GloboDocs or die.
I'm hungry.
You rang? You will scream when you take a look at the Halloween-themed Burger King Nightmare King Whopper! A product of pure voodoo. This green-tinted burger is topped with bacon, onions, and a succulent chicken patty. A burger proven again and again to invade your dreams and induce nightmares!
Oh, hello everybody, you caught me fresh after my morning workout. Today's leg day and I did 5,000 squats!
Yeah, I feel good.
By the way, the latest change that I'm instituting to the program, a little ditty that I'm kinda late to the dance for. That's right, words on the screen! That's right, this is kind of a thing that's already passed, but you know what? I feel a little bit left out because I was never aboard that bandwagon when it was popular. So I'm gonna do it, maybe for a little while at least. I'll try it out, give it the old college try, and you know, every once in a while in the show, you're just gonna see random words flash on the screen as I say them. I guess, I don't know, maybe to wake up the audience if they're falling asleep? I don't have to understand why they do it, I just have to do it! So those of you who have watched my Halloween review on the Warheads candies may look back at that review and just say, oh my god, Hottie Scotty was living a nightmare that day. Well, I hate to break and shatter the fourth wall here, but it's still not Halloween as of the time that I'm filming this, and there still exists Halloween items out there to try, and this is something called the Nightmare King Whopper! It is a thing of many trademarks. You might notice it's off-putting, off-green bun. It's definitely heavier than any hamburger that I've ever held. But the biggest selling point here, if you can believe this or not, is that it actually affects your brain. That's right, ladies and gentlemen. They say that this burger, after you ingest it, will give you nightmares when you go to sleep at night. Nightmares! Why is that a selling point? Who the hell wants nightmares even on Halloween? Who's gonna buy this item and say, oh boy, I can't wait till later tonight when I go to bed and I have some horrifying dream? And I wake up in a cold sweat and maybe peeing myself. Who the hell wants that? I am pretty sure that even the most devout horror fan doesn't want nightmares. No, when you go to sleep, that's your personal me time. You just wanna be left alone. You just wanna relax. You wanna sit and you know, bury that head in your pillow and perhaps have good dreams. But no, this is promoting that you're gonna have the worst, your worst fears are gonna come true when you go to bed at night! You think of every phobia that you have. You think of every childhood fear that has nagged your nightmares. They're all coming back for one big party, and it's all gonna happen after you eat this weird-looking hamburger. And how do I feel about that promise? Well, I'm of two minds about it. Number one, I think it's just a complete load of bubkiss to say that there's something going on with this burger here. They expect me to believe that they had some kind of weird dream experts working on this particular hamburger, or some scientists. You know, can you imagine just a big lab with all sorts of like Bunsen burners and like, you know, beakers with fire underneath them and just explosions happening here and there just to engineer the perfect nightmare burger that's gonna give you guaranteed nightmares when you go to bed at night? They didn't do that, and I bet you there's gonna be a lot of people, a lot of sick f**ks out there, who are gonna eat this burger and they're gonna hope for nightmares. And when they go to bed and they don't have a nightmare that night, they're gonna feel cheated. I think it's false advertising! But on the flip side of the coin, number two, it is scientifically proven that if you gorge yourself late at night, if you eat like all sorts of salty snacks like after the hours of 8 o'clock and then you go to bed with a full stomach, you're gonna get nightmares. So I think this burger's got a little bit of an ace in the hole because this is a freaking brick! I wouldn't even think you'd have to eat this late at night because this thing is gonna take forever to digest! This thing is like a damn cinder block in your stomach! It's gonna just keep digesting and digesting and digesting! It's gonna be like soil erosion in your stomach! That's how long it's gonna take! And another thing! Enjoy the world of the Pink Taupe. It was created by the finest restaurateurs from all corners of the world, and I personally love the ease in which fine meals are preparable. in a refrigerated tote. The approximate measurements of the finest ingredients are stored, with a helpful packet teaching you various easy-to-follow ways to prepare over 500 different types of healthy, delicious meals comparable to those you'll find at the finest 5-star restaurants. If you like a particular meal, feel free to order it again, or try one from the suggestions tab when you return the totes. I am all thumbs in the kitchen, and even a dummy like myself can prepare these exquisite meals in typically less than an hour. How can you argue with that? This week's menu includes Indian, Irish, and Italian Icelandic Inkaberry infused ice cream with iotas of imbe and Illawarra ice milk intertwined in an indigo iceberg lettuce iteration. Crock pot cooked kohlrabi and kidney bean casserole with crystallized Korean kiwi and Kalamazoo cropped kimchi with cuts of camembert and crushed kale cloves and kernels of kettle cooked corn. White wine watercress walrus Wellington wafers wetted with winter wheatgrass Worcestershire water and wound in a weird Wisconsin watermelon wedge warmed in wintergreen wombat waste on which widened waffles. Aged Alaskan albacore and aardvark aorta added with almond, apple, and alfalfa alongside al dente arugula arborio angel hair antipasto with an added assortment of au gratin avocado allotments with angelini asparagus and agar agar. So what are you waiting for? Shop online at www.therealpinktoke.com and start making healthier choices today. One more thing about this burger that may cause nightmares, and that is the hella dent it's gonna put in your wallet! For $7.29, you can get an actual burger from a diner! You can get a burger from a pretty quality restaurant! You can go to, like, Cheesecake Factory and get a burger with fries! It's bad enough that they released this the week of Halloween, which means a lot of people are gonna miss out on it because they didn't even know that it existed. But a lot of people are gonna also see that price and then be like, oh no, I'm going down to McDonald's to get me something else off the dollar menu. They're not gonna pay $7.29 for a damn burger with a false promise of nightmares. I can think of all the things I could get for $7.29. Sometimes when a Blu-ray is on sale, you can get it for like $5.99, that's a whole dollar cheaper. You can get a whole copy of the Super Mario Brothers movie to have and to own for the rest of your life. That is inexcusable. And a part of me wants that to factor into the Hoff rating when I do it at the end. Because, I mean, I've done it on other things. I mean, there's been a lot of instances where, you know, you get a bargain for the price that you're paying, and that should go towards the score. This, I mean, unless this is the most orgasmally delicious burger that I've ever had, and it's actually gonna give me nightmares about the Burger King stalking me at night, that almost has to factor into the grade.
All right, before I sink my teeth into this thing, let me just inspect what's going on the inside here. Oh, okay, we got bacon, we got onions, we got some kind of weird melted cheese here. I don't know what the heck that's all about. The beef looks a little bit off color here, and what the heck is that? What is this, like a deep-fried burger on top? Is that like a giant onion ring? What's going on here?
Introducing the Nightmare King, the spooky sandwich features 1/4 pound of savory flame-grilled beef, a 100% white meat crispy chicken filet. Is that what that was? Melted American cheese, thick-cut bacon, creamy mayonnaise, and onions all assembled on a glazed green sesame seed bun. All right, well, they don't say what the infusion of flavor there is in the bun. I guess it's just green for green's sake. I've been over this 1,000 times before. What colors represent Halloween, huh? Orange and black. We did black one year, so why can't we have the orange this year? Why did we immediately go green? What does green have to do with Halloween, huh? Am I supposed to imagine that I'm biting into a witch's head? Am I supposed to imagine that I'm gnawing on Frankenstein's cranium? So that's chicken that's in this thing. I think that's actually gonna be very delicious, but there's gonna be a lot of people out there who are not gonna be prepared for that. They don't know what the heck they're buying. I mean, when you call it a Whopper, people have a certain expectation when it comes to that. A Whopper, as far as I've been taught my entire life, has always been a cheeseburger with all the accoutrements on it. One of those accoutrements was never a giant chicken patty. They need to come up with a new term. Like, why not call this a Whopper clucker? Doesn't that tell you, the consumer, exactly what's in this thing?
And finally, let me address the elephant in the room. There are a lot of people on the internet that I've noticed that say that once you put this thing into your mouth and you chew it, you swallow it, it travels down your esophagus, travels into your stomach, digests a little bit, goes into your intestines, comes out your anus, it's gonna change your poo different colors. Nightmare Whopper, I know we just met, but I'm gonna come to your defense on this one.
That's right, I'm gonna be your lawyer! This is just another classic case of the internet talking just for the sake of talking! They said the same thing about the Angriest Whopper, they said the same thing about the Halloween Whopper, they said the same thing about the Fanta Scary Black Cherry! And every time that I've eaten one of these things for the show, because I've eaten all of them for the show, none of them change my poop different colors! You guys just want to hear yourselves way complaining, and I'm sick of it! I don't get it. Maybe if you're shitting green, then maybe that's your problem, huh? You ever think about that? All right, I better sink my teeth into this now before it gets cold on me. I am in flavor country. Well, I'll tell you what. Everybody out there who's a big fan of the Whopper, you ain't never tasted a Whopper like this, rest assured. This doesn't taste at all like the Whoppers of old because of that chicken patty that's on there. As a matter of fact, the two tastes that really jump out at you is the chicken and the cheese. Everything else that's on this Whopper may as well not be there. I mean, if you want to order a Nightmare Whopper and you're worried about your waistline, you may as well open that bun up and just peel that beef patty off of there. And while you're at it, take the bacon off of there and take the onions off of there. You don't taste any of that stuff. It just disappears. It's wallowing in oblivion. As far as I can tell, there's no taste in the green bun. I mean, I guess it's just green for the sake of Halloween. But I am noticing that on this little wrapping that they gave me, the grease that you actually see, like usually permeating through this thing, it's colored green, so I'll leave it up to your imagination as to what this is doing to your insides. Now, I can see why it's so expensive, because not only are you getting this weird experimental bun, but it's like buying two sandwiches. It's like buying a burger and a chicken sandwich all in one. But, like I said before, the burger just absolutely disappears. You don't taste the beef at all. So what are you left with? I mean, it's definitely not worth the money. I mean, as good as it is, it's not worth no $7.29. It's a fun little novelty, but are people really gonna remember this? Is this gonna go down in the annals of time as a warm, fuzzy memory of people's childhoods? The kind of way that I feel about Holiday Spiced Pepsi? Somehow I tend to doubt it. So if I were to give this a Hoff rating, I'd definitely have to put it in a 3.5 Hoff range. I'm gonna rank it pretty high because it really is delicious for what you get, but I am gonna have to take a little bit of points off because when people buy this, they're expecting to get a Whopper. That's a flame broiled beef sandwich with all the fixins. Like, I mean, there was no lettuce on here, there was no tomatoes on here. Now, typically that's stuff that I take off the burger anyway, but a lot of people, they might be expecting that. This doesn't have anything like that, and it has a giant chicken patty on there that completely takes away the taste of the beef. I said in a prior review that presentation is important. Well, calling this a Whopper was kind of like the death knell for this sandwich. But I can't slam it too hard because the chicken and the cheese do taste delicious. It's just the other stuff, I wouldn't even know if it tastes delicious because it's just not there. So I guess there's nothing left to do but eat the rest of this sucker and see if it infects my dreams.
Well, good night, everybody.
Here's sponsor. Stradex! Now, how do I explain? Each container of Stradex has these little paper gimmicks soaked in a special solution. You apply these paper gimmicks to your face and then dry out the oils, the dirt, and the toxins. So if you got a big old pus-filled gimmick on your face, you use this paper gimmick on that gimmick and you wash that gimmick away. Then you be sure to put the cat gimmick on the other gimmick over there. Don't want any of your paper gimmicks drying out, now do you? What? I said now do you, you piece of trash! I'm about ready to stick a ham bone right in that gimmick you call a face! But I wouldn't dirty my hands hitting the guy with all those zits!
What?
Blackheads!
What?
Pockmarks!
What?
Moles!
What?
Warts!
What?
Gimmicks!
What?
All over his face! That's why you gotta buy yourself some Stradex! And that's the bottom line, cause Ted Fowler said so!